Any person who has a well-founded fear of being persecuted for reasons of race, religion, nationality, or political opinion, who is outside of his or her country, and who is afraid to seek the protection of that country. More than 500,000 Salvadorian refugees are scattered throughout the world, and 500,000 have sought refuge within El Salvador. The eruptions within El Salvador have caused this human volcano. The Salvadorian government, through its armed forces, brutally and shamelessly represses the Salvadorian civilians, the majority campesinos. These people are obliged to flee their country to save their lives. These refugees are proof of the persecution, of the utter lack of human rights that Salvadorian people suffer. The Salvadorian campesino, having no other means of escape, searches out the closest exit, Honduras. They abandon their homes. They hide by day to escape the bombs that the armed forces drop on defenseless civilians. They creep along by night, sleeping on beds of mountain brush, eating leaves and roots, drinking their own urine. With all of this, the psychological trauma is tremendous. They've suffered the loss of their homes, of their few belongings. They have presenced rapes, arbitrary captures, massacres of entire communities. Plunging themselves into the hell of Honduras, the refugees escaped the fire of El Salvador. In 1980, the first camp in Honduran territory was established, named La Virtud. After 1 year, the government of Honduras, along with the United Nations High Commission for Refugees, forced the refugees to be relocated from La Virtud to a camp named Mesa Grande, located 30 miles inside of Honduras. With this maneuver, the Honduran government intended to clear from the border zone all witnesses of Honduran intervention in the Salvadorian conflict. A second camp is located in Colomancagua, 4 kilometers from the Salvadorian border of the Department of Morazan. There, the refugees have constructed 7 camps, Limones 1, Limones 2, Quebrachito, Callejón, Copinol, Las Vegas, and San Antonio. One of the duties of the United Nations High Commission for Refugees is to guarantee the protection of the Salvadorian refugees in Honduras. But in none of these camps do the refugees express confidence in having this protection. The governments of Honduras and El Salvador share an intimate alliance. As such, the Honduran armed forces exercise constant repression against the refugees. The refugees count many cases of arbitrary captures, of tortures, of searches, of disappearances, of assassinations, of fellow refugees who have been turned over to the Salvadorian authorities, violating norms established by the United Nations. But in spite of these insecure conditions, in spite of constant violations to the most basic rights, the refugees have forged a new life. The camp of Colomancagua is proof of this.
Salud, 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 salud.
Children, what are your names?
Niños, ¿cómo se llaman?
Yo me llamo Leonidas.
Yo me llamo David.
Yo me llamo Carmen. Yo Marco.
¿Y usted?
And you?
¿De dónde vienen?
De El Salvador.
El Salvador.
¿En dónde están?
En Colombia.
Where are you from? El Salvador. Where are you now? In the refugee camp in Colomancagua.
Nosotros
Somos campesinos salvadoreños. Hemos venido aquí, a Colomoncagua, Honduras.
We are Salvadorian campesinos. We're here because of violations of our persons and of our rights. Every day this happens in El Salvador. We've come here walking days on end, tired, hungry, thirsty, suffering from the loss of our homes, our loved ones, our lives.
Y también con mucho dolor por haber perdido a mucho de lo que queríamos.
On December 13, 1980, we arrived in Colomoncagua. Since that day, we've struggled to reconstruct our lives.
La sostención de los campamentos se hace por medio de las diferentes áreas de trabajo que hay.
We maintain our life in the camps through the different jobs. Some of us work in the garden. Others make hammocks, others are in the embroidery shop, others in sewing, making pants for the children and clothes in general. Other people work in construction, building schools, kitchens, nutrition centers, health centers.
De las escuelas, de las cocinas, de los centros de nutrición, de los centros de salud.
Others make shoes, meeting the needs of so many who have gone barefoot. We're making tremendous progress. We're campesinos and we're capable people. We know how to work, but we don't just work. Our objective is to always be learning new things so we can teach others. We don't work for our own money, but for the benefit of the community as a whole.
Trabajamos por el bien de toda la comunidad.
How many people live here? There are 6,600 people here. Of these, 4,500 are children.
De estos hay 4,500 niños.
What role do the United Nations and the voluntary agencies play? The agencies that most help us are SEDEN, the United Nations, Caritas,
SEDEN, ACNUR, Caritas.
People come to teach us things like embroidery, to give us training and education, we have a long list of tasks that we are able to do because of the help these people give us. The materials come from far away. We truly appreciate all of this, even though we don't know where it all comes from.
A todo esto, pues, ya que no podemos decir de dónde vienen, pero sí sabemos de que vienen de muy lejos.
Christmas came and went. For a moment, we've been happy. Because here, within our camp, we felt the prospect that the day is near
que el año nuevo vendrá.
When our new year will be here.
Dimos las gracias a Dios.
We gave our thanks to God.
Con los tres reyes de Oriente.
And the three kings of the Orient.
Que al calor de nuestra gente.
That with the warmth of all our people.
Podemos sobrevivir.
Survival we will have.
Y por las instituciones.
And for the institutions.
Pedimos a Dios y damos gracias.
We bid goodbye and give our thanks.
Que nos dan valor y vida.
They give us life
y
and strength.
La democracia.
Democracy by which to live.
Ya con esta me despido.
With this I'll say goodbye.
Ya les canto esta canción.
Singing you this song.
Que en todos los campamentos.
That here in all these camps.
Amamos la institución.
The institutions are our friends.
Soy refugiado aquí en Colomoncagua. Vine el 80 en diciembre.
Refugee. I came in December of 80. After arriving and seeing our need,
venido,
we asked the agencies for cement to make water tanks.
Pusimos, pedir cemento y hacer unas pilas donde había unas corrientes de agua.
We built the tanks, and then we asked
cemento,
for tubes to bring the water so we could plant some small
tubes.
Gardens. They don't fill all our needs, though, because we don't have enough land. But we keep on working, boys and adults, always together, watering the gardens every single day. And now we're harvesting for all the refugees, even though the quantities are small.
Siempre para todos los refugiados, aunque poco.
Also, we're starting to prepare two small fields of corn. We need to learn and to keep up the production. Just because we're refugees, it doesn't mean that we can't fulfill our desires. We're Salvadorians, and we have to work wherever we are to produce our food.
Y por tantitos que a entrenar el trabajo, porque es que es preciso que todos aprendamos. No privar de la unción, no porque estamos refugiados. Poner en la unción nuestras esperanzas, porque somos salvadoreños y tenemos que trabajar a donde quiera que nos encontremos para conseguir nuestros alimentos.
Long live the refugees, Long live our spirit. Right here, we're creating our ministry of progress. Students, one and all, laurels you'll be bestowed. You're the leaders of tomorrow, the light of our well-being. Oh, my glittering optimists, let's not lose this occasion to be patriots for the future of our nation.
¿Quién es usted?
Yo soy una refugiada salvadoreña. Trabajo en salud como encargada en colonia.
I'm a Salvadorian refugee.
Lo que podía explicar es
I'm the health representative for our group of 10 tents for 120 people.
Porque
when we came here,
venimos aquí, pues,
we were sick, the children and all.
Veníamos enfermos, los niños.
We didn't
y
know
todos,
what to do.
Y no sabíamos cómo hacer esto.
Con la inteligencia de nosotros y la participación de todos.
But using our intelligence and with everybody's participation, we elected health workers. We started with prevention, keeping the camps clean, bathing the children daily, washing their hands. Then the doctors came, who gave us lectures that we give to our community. We don't have many medicines. We have to use our intelligence to make do until we receive new supplies.
Son pocos los que vienen, pero con la inteligencia de nosotros los hacemos que los alcancen hasta el tiempo que vienen el medicamento.
Before, I didn't know anything about any of this. I was a campesina. I didn't go to school.
No,
I didn't know how to read or write. But here in the camps, I've learned, and that's why I can work in health, using our intelligence and the cooperation of all the refugees.
En el refugio, he aprendido un poquito de educación y fue como pude aprender de salud con la inteligencia de nosotros y de todos los refugiados.
We have a nutrition center here where we treat the malnourished children. The international institutions send donations of different foods to help the malnourished children and elderly people.
Ingresamos los niños desnutridos por las ayudas internacional de las instituciones. Los vienen alimentos de distintas clases para poder ingresar a los niños desnutridos.
El 27 de mayo
On the 27th of May, we opened our center. To all the malnourished children, we gave them their dinners. And I beg all my friends to take the precaution. Please use water that's boiled to avoid the infection. And now I'll beg you goodbye, singing you this song. Perhaps when I see you again, it will be in El Salvador.
Sí, el programa de educación.
The education program is functioning well. When we first came, we wanted to promote education, but we didn't have any materials.
Deseábamos promover la educación.
But now we do have enough materials and enough skills to teach the children to read and write.
Pero así poco a poco fuimos ubicándolos en la educación y hoy tenemos suficiente material y ahora tenemos la suficiente capacidad para enseñar a leer y a escribir a todos los niños. Y más que todo no se trata solamente de que aprendan a leer y a escribir, sino que más que todo que ellos vivan en unión, ¿verdad?
It's not just teaching them to read and write. Perhaps more importantly is to teach them to live in unity. Everybody who's in school also works in other areas. The children work in carpentry shops, in tinsmith.
Por ejemplo, los niños trabajan en talleres de carpintería, de hojalatería, talabartería, y en sastrería.
They make shoes and clothes, as well as coming to classes, children and adults.
Tanto adultos como los niños. las clases las impartimos nosotros los mismos refugiados, ¿verdad? Somos campesinos y...
We do all the teaching. We're campesinos, but what little we know, we share.
Estamos compartiendo lo que nosotros podemos a los mismos.
Also, people come, sponsored by the agencies, who give us training and education.
Por parte de las instituciones, algunos que lo están dando capacitación para que nosotros podamos adelantar en la educación.
Our objective is to no longer live in the misery we suffered in El Salvador. We know the lack of education kept us in our dire poverty.
Porque veíamos que la falta de educación nos ha hecho tal vez vivir en alguna miseria, ¿va?
Here in the refugee camps, we've discovered that it's important to learn to read, to educate ourselves. In El Salvador, we couldn't go to school because we were too poor.
Y ya no los pudimos educar porque como éramos campesinos y no podíamos porque la situación económica que teníamos no los permitía aprender a estudiar.
Out of 6,600 refugees, about 5,000 people participate in the education program.
Sí, aproximadamente son 5,000 los que están participando en la educación, ¿no? Y ya vemos por todos los refugiados como 6,600 personas, ¿verdad?
The teacher of a people must be very conscious. To continue on our march, no steps to be taken back. And if we're good teachers and the children are well behaved, we'll always remember that we've been refugees. The words, for the people, indicate unity. We have to search it out with all our hearts. And so I bid goodbye to all my compañeros. Buried deep within me are the memories that I've been here in school.
¿Puede explicar algo acerca de su área de trabajo?
Sí. Después que entramos aquí a Colomuncagua, nos hemos organizado con la gente.
When we got to Colomuncagua, we began organizing ourselves. Some of us coordinated the camps, others coordinating the different areas.
Áreas de salud,
health, housing, special projects, various jobs that each day we organize better and better.
Se van cada día organizando más. También la celebración de la palabra de Dios.
Also, the celebration of the Word of God. The Christian religion teaches us to love each other.
Bueno, la religión cristiana nos enseña que nos amemos unos a otros.
The lectures of the evangelists, the letters of the apostles, show us the first Christian community where you see the love that existed for everybody.
donde
many people sold their land, their possessions, to share with those who didn't have anything.
Había un amor para todos.
In that Christian community, you live your love for God, for your sisters and brothers, because there isn't anybody who needs to have more. Everything's equal. It's a beautiful community to understand better, to live the compromise of loving each other. Everything is done in collective, in unity.
Es una comunidad muy bonita para ir entendiendo lo mejor, para un compromiso de que se vive el amor del uno al otro y en colectivo de todo lo que se trabaja, es una unidad de todos.
The Mass has come to an end. We've heard what God has said. We know what to do and we can walk. Our work we have to start. When the poor believe in the poor, liberty we will sing. When the poor believe in the poor, fraternity we will forge.
Les vamos a contar un poco de nuestra vida aquí.
Our life in the camps.
Siempre,
we work well
no
here, but never without problems.
No
you see, we can't leave the boundary of these camps. Also, we're afraid that because of bad weather or bad luck, the firewood and the food will not arrive.
También nos preocupa que en días pasados hemos tenido visitas improvisadas.
We also worry because in the past we've had surprise visitors.
Con esta historia hablaríamos de la alegría, de la tristeza de estar dentro de otro país.
To continue with this story, we must speak of the happiness, of the sadness of living in a foreign country. But we continue working. In spite of the difficulties we have here, where thousands of us suffer, we live with a hope that is always growing and always advancing, searching for the future, searching for tomorrow. A tomorrow when all of what we're learning here, we will use to lay the path to find the light to create our future in El Salvador.
Y en nuestro pueblo.
I'm from Tiroa. You'll find me sad because I'm here, far from my home. How I remember my Osikala, my Arambala, and my Perkin. I'm a refugee. You'll find me fleeing because their terror is threatening me. Off in my land, my mother died. Of all my family, only I've survived.
El hondureño me ha dado abrigo y eso me alegra en mi aflicción. Gracias le digo a mis amigos, se lo digo de corazón.
The Hondurans have given me shelter.
Amigos, te lo digo de corazón.
and this consoles me in my pain.
Ya me despido triste y alegre, pues algún día he de volver. Mientras tanto llego en Sevilla, con la esperanza le digo adiós. Mientras tanto llego en Sevilla, con la esperanza le digo adiós.
Thanks, I say, to all my friends. And this I do with all my heart. Sad and happy, I bid goodbye, for someday soon I will return. Until that day has come, with a heart of hope, I say adios. Destruction is threatening all the work that has been done by the Salvadorian refugees in Honduras. The constant threats for a new relocation are stronger and stronger. Knocking at the door is the relocation of both Colomancagua and Mesa Grande to deep within the interior of Honduras. Who is behind all of this? Why is there so much pressure to relocate the refugees that are on the Salvadorian border? Clearing the border zone of any witnesses to military action is part of the escalating intervention that Honduras and the United States are playing in Central America. The Commission of Human Rights of El Salvador echoes the petition of the Salvadorian refugees in Honduras. No to the relocation.